I'm live. I did it. Here I am. Happy Sunday. Welcome to another episode of Tea Time, the live stream for all of the nerds and everyone else. I was just over on the green room, which is our pre-tea time hangout. On Zoom, which was very fun. We were having a grand old time cracking up. And we were talking about how talking to my friend John, I was like, what is it? What is the word for when you stay up too late and you feel like you have a hangover but you didn't drink and then you have to get up in the morning? I was like, what's the cool word that we can use? And he was just like, it's called getting old, which is totally true. I was up late too la Nope, I was up too late last night. Had a really fun gig with Pamela Parker's Fantastic Machine in Livermore, California, at this really cool venue called Almost Famous. And I hadn't been there. I had heard about this venue for a long time. Really good sound. They had wine. I don't drink wine. It looked good. It looked tasty. Other people liked it. Just all of the employees were super, super nice. And yeah, it was super fun. The stage sounded really good. Sometimes in small spaces, it's really hard to have really good stage sound. But very fun. The only thing that was hard was that the stage lights were so bright. I couldn't see the audience at all. So, and the problem was the audience was so respectful that I couldn't hear them either. So I had to, after every song, the lights would sort of dim, you know, because they had a cool lighting guy. And then I'd be like, oh, there you are. But everybody was so nice and it was a great crowd. Friend Charlie showed up. Thanks for showing up, Charlie. That was such a good surprise. And it was good to play with the wreckage again. It's been since October, I think, since we had played Trio Vibes. Very, very fun. But hopefully I'll play there again, because it was so much fun. My next show in the Bay is That hangover is April 6th. We moved our house concert to April 6th in San Francisco in a cool, quiet neighborhood. It's called Echoes in the Valley House Concert Series. I'll be playing with one of my best buds, Jasmine Pritchard. And I think her band is called Jasmine Pritchard and the Reluctant Sparkles or something like that. I don't know. It's very cute. I like it a lot. But it's gonna be really fun, and if you want to come, you can RSVP at Echoes in the Valley Concerts at gmail.com. Nice Saturday show. But anyway, it's good to see you all. Happy Saturday. No, Sunday. My brain is broken. I went to bed at 2:30 last night. Couldn't help it. It's post-show energy. They gave me a falafel salad. So I ate that way too late, and then I'm up, just being all excited, happy that I got to play rock and roll with my friends. Yeah, it's good stuff. Check out Pamela Parker's Fantastic Machine. They are indeed fantastic. Her voice is incredible, like flawless, and the a killer guitar player. Slays. Yeah. So, yeah. So much fun. Got back from Atlanta, Athens. I played the Cracker, the band. I played their camp in, an annual like festival they put on at this really cool club called the 40 Watt, which I hear, correct me if I'm wrong, if you know different. We used to be some sort of like convenience store. And so it has a really open floor plan with a stage sort of the back middle, but they have seating kind of all around. And unlike other venues that you have access, it's rare with a venue when you have access to the sides, you kind of don't hear it very well because you're kind of behind the band. But they put speakers and chairs, choking on my tea. And it was, yeah, so much fun. I like it. The sound in there is really cool, and it feels like a cool rock club. And yeah, kind of because of Casey Turner, my manager and friend, I had not known, other than being a little kid learning the couple of Cracker songs that came on the radio on guitar, I had really wasn't familiar with their stuff. And through the gigs that Casey's put us opening for them at Hot Monk Novato, and then they asked me to do this camp in, I have become a huge fan of not only their music, but of the band in general. And like, you know, when I think of rock and rollers or rock stars, you know, not to, everybody has a different view, but I always picture like unapproachable, kind of frightening, like this entity that shall not be, like, don't go near it. But these guys are so freaking nice, and not to like pop the bubble of like mystique, but like above and beyond. Like, I got a tour of downtown Athens. The bass player took me around to these music stores. It was so cool. We played bass guitars and old vintage guitars at just a couple of stores before a gig. So much fun. Yeah. Anyway, loved it. Had fun. All right, let me look at these comments. Thanks for joining, by the way. I really appreciate it. It's nice to see you. Marks, you said that when the getting old hangover is called night terrors, which I also agree with. Definitely. You do miss the Pepper poster, but I want to tell you it's my turn to look at the Pepper poster. I'm just kidding. It's right in front of me. I do. I should put the Pepper poster on that wall. It's just an empty wall. It's a great idea, Alfred. Daphne says we got to talk about Autopilot. Oh, I'm so glad you like that song. That was my last Patreon song, Autopilot. I never know what's gonna come, like, be the inspiration. I will start out even sometimes with a, this is what I'm writing this month. I'm specifically gonna write or finish this idea or do this thing. But I've learned to sort of like not put that in like chains and just sort of like listen to whatever comes up. And if something else just hits me in the moment, even while writing something specific, I might chase it for a second and see if it's something else. And my friend Jerry had taught me, and this is might be a little shameful, but I had never really done MIDI before. And MIDI is like this, it's I don't even know, it's like note values. I don't know. Somebody explain MIDI to me. I don't know what it is. But it's instead of live audio, you can draw notes in a grid, essentially, or play them on a controller, and it will, or a piano, a keyboard, which I have right here, which you can't see, and it will draw the notes, and then you can change the sound without having to re-record a live instrument. And MIDI hasn't always been amazing, but so I hadn't played piano in a long time, and I had been playing around because I needed to understand, I needed to know how to do it. I finally did it. But then I started playing the piano again because I'd been playing, you know, and then I just came up with this idea where it was just like this one note, bing, 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 bing. And since I don't really know how to play piano, I wrote the song with just the right hand. First, it was just the left hand. And I didn't really know how, yeah, I don't really play piano. I haven't played piano since I was 7. But when you change your instrument on yourself, it gives you all of these new flavors and colors to work with. And it just started coming out. It's like all of these feelings that of being a human is so complicated. So complicated, you guys. So hard. I guess I'd been feeling a kind of way for a while. And so I wrote and recorded that song, and it didn't take a super long time because I guess it was just under the surface. But I had to record the piano in two parts. So I recorded the right hand and then I recorded the left hand and put them together. But someday I plan to learn how to play them as one. But yeah, that was a long explanation. But yeah. Anyway, I should play some songs. Oops, sorry, guilt. It's a little thing. Oh, Beth. Hi, Beth. Thank you for joining. Oh, Mark, you liked Like Your Parents Did? Thank you. That's a song I wrote with James DePrato. We released it on Patreon, like, very early. And it was like a studio version. We may have done it. I think we... Did we do that one with Jerry? I don't know. It was a long time ago. Yeah, that was a fun, it's fun. I need to write more songs with my band members. They're just, they have so many good ideas. But, yeah. I'm gonna play a song. So, this theme, this theme is a little weird. And I'm gonna tell you, it was born out of being... I came home really late from the gig last night. I had no time, as per usual, I had no time to figure out songs pre the actual tea time. And so I opened up my song list that I used to play songs from back when I was a kid. You know, I'd play, people would hire me to play their weddings or their parties, and I built up a big song list of songs that I used to play. I don't remember very many of them, but I'm like scrolling through, like deliriously tired, you know, eating falafel salad, also hyped up at the same time because I just came home from a gig, knowing that I have to go to bed because I have to wake up for tea time. And yeah, I scrolled to the eyes. And I was like, okay, my theme for this one is just going to be a very, like, it's going to be the ego list. And it's going to be all songs that start with the word I. So we're just going to go for it. What's the first one? Okay, the first one is, I have played this song before. But I don't know if I've done it on Tea Time. But I'm gonna do this. It's totally fried. Let me know how it sounds, and I can adjust the sound. Okay.
It was late last night. I was feeling that something wasn't right. There was not another soul in sight. Only you, only you. So we walked along, though I knew that there was something wrong. And the feeling hit me oh so strong. about you. Then you gazed up at me, and the answer was plain to see, 'cause I saw the light in your eyes, in your eyes. Though we had our fling, I just never was a specter thing, till that little bell began to ring in my head, in my head. But I tried to run,
scrolling,
and though I knew it wouldn't help no one, 'cause I could never, never love no one, or so I said. But my feelings were true, were something I never knew, till I saw the light in your eyes, in your eyes.
Guitar solo. It's a really good guitar solo. Do you know the song, Todd Rundgren? I saw the light, parentheses, in your eyes.
But I loved you the best. It's not something I say in jest, 'cause you're different from all the rest in my eyes. And I ran for too long, 'cause I saw the light in your eyes, in your eyes, in your eyes, in your eyes.
It might actually be a Carole King song. You're right. Todd Rundgren either did it or covered it. But I do feel like Carole King wrote a lot of songs for other people. Let's look it up. Dear Google. Dearest Google. Who wrote in... No. Yeah. In you... No. I saw the light. I saw the light. I saw the light, Hank Williams song. No. No. Can't be. I saw the light in your eyes. Dearest Google, who wrote, says Todd Rundgren. I kind of don't believe that though. It's funny. I bet I'm doing this right now. Hi, everybody. Look, my brother, Tommy Slanks, has joined. For some reason, I'm Googling on a live stream who wrote I Saw the Light by Todd Rundgren. Or maybe not by Todd Rundgren. Let's see. Songwriters, Todd Rundgren. All right, you could have knocked me over with a feather. But she did it. Didn't she do it? I can hear her voice doing it. She's such a badass. Anyway. Because she did a lot of songwriting for other people, just like Bruce Springsteen did, and Bobby D, Robert Dylan. I should have done my vocal warm ups. It's all dry. It's like you didn't drink enough water after your gig, Megan. Anyway, that's the first song. It's not an egotistical song, but it did start with the I. I wrote down a few that I could probably bring out. Yeah. So I'm gonna go back to the comments for a second. Yes, John, I'm so sorry that we rescheduled and the house concert, and now you have a Giants game. But have fun at the Giants. Go Giants. I will be doing another Giants anthem. They asked me again in June, which will be really fun. Terrifying. Terrifying. It will be very terrifying. I don't know why I say yes to those things. I say yes because baseball. Going through. Oh, you never logged the last month's tea time? Well, I didn't log it either, so join the team. I'll try to go through last tea time and find out what those songs were. But thanks for doing that when is possible, and don't ever feel any pressure to do it. I use the tea time login. We're like, Tom runs that. It's like a Google sheet that has like when I played what song, which is very helpful because sometimes I'm like, have I ever done this song? Well, I've done it 15 times. Maybe I'll do a different song. Let's see. Bop, bop, boop, bop, bop, beep, 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 beep. Oh, yes, there's a new date for the house concert, Tommy Slanks. It's April 6th, Saturday, April 6th. Echoes in the Valley House Concert Series. Join us if you can. It's going to be very fun. Please come. What's the Giants record when you sing the anthem? Well, that's a really good question. At first, when I sang the anthem, I thought I was a really bad luck charm because they lost a lot. But I think it was just a bad season for them. They've had a few. But it could have been me. But I am happy to report that they have won the last several games that I sang the anthem for. So at least I've turned something around. I'd hate for it to be like the Giants are just like, we can't ask you again. In fact, you can't come because the team always loses when you sing your weird rendition of this song. But that hasn't happened yet. Knock on wood. Which came first, your love of baseball or your love of the Giants? Or was it simultaneous? That is a great question. Baseball. Because my dad used to play softball, which when you're a kid, you think they're the same thing. In fact, I honestly still kind of think that they're the same thing. It's because I don't know anything about sports. My dad used to play, I think it was every Friday. For our neighborhood team, all of the dudes on the neighborhood had this softball team, and my dad was first base, and he got really into it, and it was so much fun. And you know, we'd watch the game, but we'd also hang out and play, and they became like really special to me. And so I just developed a love of the sport because of that. And then you know, occasionally my parents would take us to an A's game and we'd sit in the bleachers being all cold, you know, like eating concessions back when they were affordable. Back before a beer cost $15 and a hot dog was... I don't even want to talk about it. Who was I talking to yesterday? It was like yesterday or the day before. Oh, so I've become friends with the grocer in my neighborhood. And we chat about all things San Francisco. And he told me that there was an article in the newspaper that said that burritos, there's a place in San Francisco now charges $22 for a burrito. And that's just the regular, not the like fancy one. $22 for a burrito. Insanity. I mean, it better be a really good burrito. I mean, they are very good here. We have some good burritos. But $22? You guys, I don't even know what to say. It's just not fair. Burritos used to be the cheap food that bands ate before gigs because we couldn't afford anything else. Now we have to cut it three ways. Anyway, that's a lot of beans. That's so many beans. It is. It's ridiculous. I love burritos, but damn. Yes, correct. Gold flaked tortilla. I mean, what makes a $22 burrito $22? Is it gigantic? Is it like family sized? Burritos are supposed to be family sized for one person anyway. I don't know. But that brings me back to the baseball, because we would go out to eat, and my parents were like, we're all three little kids, and my parents were, scrimping and saving, and us going out to eat was going to Taco Bell, and we loved it. And those burritos, if you can call them burritos, sorry if anybody works at Taco Bell. Honestly, I still really love them. Is that bad to say? There's something very nostalgic about a Taco Bell burrito. But we would go out to eat, and we would go to Taco Bell, and we'd get everything off of the, what was it, 59 cents or something menu? 59 cents for a burrito? Now it's $22? To be fair, those are two completely different kinds of burritos. Like the Taco Bell burrito, you can't hold because it just falls over your hand. Yeah. The burritos here are gigantic. Like, don't, you shouldn't eat a whole one, but I do. Not anymore, but I used to. Plate-sized ones, yeah. Wait, are they? They're still $10 in. Are you still in Santa Cruz, Merlin? Because that's, see, $10 burrito, that's good. Like, it's a treat. You still go out, you get some. I remember coming to San Francisco and they would be like $6.75 for a vegetarian burrito. And I'd be like, bring it on. All I need is the beans, the rice, the tortilla, some pico de gallo. Now I want a burrito, you guys. Anyway, not a $22 one. $59.79 and 99 cent menu. Thank you. So my parents were like, you can get three things off the 59 cent burrito menu or one thing off the, I don't know. But it was awesome and I cherish those memories a lot. For baseball. Yeah. Baseball slash going out to eat at Taco Bell. Good stuff. All right. You like Taco Bell too? I don't know. The little salsa packets. Can you call it salsa? Hot sauce? It's good. So good. Tour food. Such tour food. Capitola these days. Okay, cool. California makes a burrito $22. It's, yeah, that's a thing. I think it's more of a Bay Area thing than a California thing, but yeah. Don't you just want burritos now? Going to the mall as a teen, you could eat for $2. It's true. It's true, and that's a lot. It's burrito time. Guys, sorry to call this early, but I gotta go eat a $22 burrito. I gotta go spend last night's paycheck on tonight's dinner for a burrito. Anyway, let's play another song, shall we? Sorry that we've got on a burrito tangent. Which one of these do I want to do? I'm gonna do. Oh man, there's just so many songs that start with an I. Okay, I'm going to do this song, Racha. Boop beep ba. Nope. How do I go to my? Nope. Yep. Okay, found it. Nobody panic. Gotta drink more water. I'll do this song. Okay. So many I songs. Okay, we're gonna go here. Excuse me. I can tell there's another hiccup coming, but it's okay. I think you can tell who this is before I start singing. Just because this picking pattern or strumming pattern.
Well, I won't back down. won't back down. You can stand me up at the gates of hell, but I won't back down. Gonna stand my ground, won't be turned around. And I keep this world from dragging me down. Gonna stand my ground, and I won't back down.
There's a guitar solo and stuff like that, but I won't subject you to me just being like, there's a guitar solo here. That's Tom Petty. I won't back down. So we've done I Saw the Light and I Won't Back Down. Last Dance for Mary Jane is a great song. Good old Tom. Gotta love some Petty. Yeah, I like that song. Beep bop boop bop. What other I songs? It's funny. It's the whole reason I got on this kick was because I was so tired. I didn't want to keep scrolling through my list. I was like, I made it to this letter. Let's just stick around here for a while. I found another good one to do. But what else? I was going to tell you guys about other stuff, but I can't remember what it is. It's because I just talk so much. Yeah, what's going on? What's new? What's new? Mark, you saw him live back in the day? They handed out 45s of American Girl after the gig. Can you imagine? That's so cool. Oh my gosh. Do you still have that 45? Because that's dope. That's really cool. Yeah, it's good stuff. What else was I gonna tell you guys? We talked about the cracker camping. That was fun. I can tell my brain is just like chugging along. I think it needs calories, and I definitely need to drink. I did not drink enough water at the gig last night. they had a great backstage with all these snacks and all this stuff, but you know, my weird thing that I do of, did I tell you about this? I did. I told you about this. You might not all have heard this weirdness. You think I'm weird already. Just wait till you hear this thing. For a fun experiment, I collect my garbage for the year, just to see how much there is. I've been trying to reduce my, like, you know, fruit stickers. You pull off a fruit sticker or like the tape off of a box that you've mailed, and things like that. And I've been trying to like reduce the amount of things I buy that are in packages. This is a long, boring anecdote for no reason, but I'm almost done. So they had water bottles, snacks that I just wanted to open up, but they were just, I was like, I know if I open up that bag of delicious chips that look so good, I'm going to have to take the garbage home and put it in my collection. So anyway, I didn't, but they also had water bottles and I didn't drink water last night and I didn't eat snacks last night, and I can tell I'm paying for it this morning, aside from also getting up right before tea time. And they have slept in a little bit longer than I meant to. I could tell I still have morning voice. Also, I'm still have PJs on. Sorry. Who else is having a lazy Sunday? Hit me up. I got my Earl Grey with my cashew milk. Doing cashew milk now. It's very delish. And some cinnamon in there for fanciness. Yeah. Oh, Mark. Oh, I'm so sorry that your mom threw out all your Beatles sleeves. Ugh. Yeah, I one time lent my Sgt. Pepper. Well, let me rephrase that. I lent my parents Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band record to my cousin. And you know how it comes with the cutouts? She returned it. Cutouts weren't in there. I was like, where are my cutouts? And she was like, I don't know. I have a Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band without the cutouts. Without the mustache. Anyway. Yeah. I have to fix my record player, but... You're wearing your Megan the Slankard record t-shirt? And breaking in your new hiking boots? Are you going for a hike? That sounds fun. That's a good Sunday thing to do. Go for a hike. Get some outdoors. Ooh, caramel cinnamon coffee. Ooh, that sounds so good. That sounds amazing. Coming over to your house, Beth. Yeah. Going on an Alaskan cruise in June, so you're breaking in your hiking boots. That's a good idea. Okay, I'm gonna sing another song. Because I've only sang two. Typical Megan. This is another I song. You'll know this one. Wise men say, only fools are ashen, but I can't help falling in love with you. like a river.
said gently to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be, so take my hand, take my whole life too, for I can't help falling in love with you, for I can't help falling. Such a pretty song.
So Elvis sings that song. Who wrote that song?
Shall we Google another Google? Dearest Google, who wrote I Can't Help Falling in Love with You? Was written by Hugo Peretti, Luigi Creator, and George David Weiss. And published by Gladys Music Incorporated. Ooh, the melody is based on a French word, d'amour. I should learn some French. Yes, it's a great song. It's beautiful. It's a chef's kiss song. Yeah. And Elvis sure sang the heck out of it. Yeah, cool. Well, I've learned something today. That's good. It's a good day when you learn something. Ooh, I haven't seen Priscilla yet, George. Is it good? I should see it. I should watch it. I almost watched it on the plane on the way home from Athens, but I fell asleep instead. And I always choose to fall asleep over a movie if possible, because it just makes the trip so much shorter. Oh, I Left My Heart in San Francisco. That would have been a good one to do. But I don't know that song. I should learn it, though. But that's thinking. So we've done I Saw the Light, I Won't Back Down, and I Can't Help Falling in Love, parentheses, with you. What about? Oh, I know a good one. Why did I choose this theme? I don't know, you guys. There's not always a rhyme nor a reason. Oh my God, so many eyes. Okay, what about this one? It's kind of fun. I want a pizza dated. Do I know that song? That's a good one. I don't know if I know that song. I wanna be sedated. The Ramones, you guys. I was one of those girls with the Ramones t-shirt back, but I know people always call out girls for wearing rock and roll t-shirts and they don't know who the band is, but I knew who the band was. Okay. It's like 20, 24 hours to go. I wanna be sedated. Nothing to do, nowhere to go. I wanna be sedated. Just get me to the airport, put me on a plane. Hurry, 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 before I go insane. I can't control my fingers, I can't control my brain. Oh. 24 hours to go. I wanna be sedated. nothing to do, nowhere to go. I wanna be sedated. Put me in a wheelchair, get me on a plane. Hurry, hurry, hurry before I go insane. I can't control my fingers, I can't control my brain.
Bow, 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 bow. Yeah. Great song. Great song. I'm gonna add that I did that. Be sedated. Okay. I did half of a song there, but that was fun. Now what about, I know another good one. What about this one? I keep losing my YouTube video. No. Okay.
I thought love was only true in fairy tales, meant for someone else but not for me. Love is out to get me, that's the way it seemed. Disappointment haunted all my dreams. Now I saw her face, now I'm a believer. Not a chance, a doubt in my mind. I'm in love, ooh, I'm a believer. I could leave her if I tried.
I don't know that.
I thought love was more or less a given thing. Seems the more I gave, the less I got. What's the use in trying? All you get is pain. When I needed sunshine, I got rain.
But I love the rain.
But then I saw her face. I'm a believer. Not a trace. Out of my mind. Now I'm in love. Ooh, I'm a believer. I can leave her if I try.
Is there a bridge to this song? I don't think so.
Then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace.
Something like that. Is that the Monkees? I think that was the Monkees. That's a good song. Good song. I am the walrus. Come on. That's a great suggestion. Goo 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 choo. Let's see. Often called out for being a Beatles fan because you were born in 64. Whatever, like who you like. That's definitely true. Like who you like. So does this song go into the Tea Time Tracker? I don't know, Tom. We have to come up with another category of where's she going now? What's she doing with this? A whole new tab for tangents. You just stage dived in the living room? That's the kind of Sunday I want to hear about right there. Beep bop boop bop bop bop. Neil Diamond wrote that great. Neil Diamond wrote that song? I saw her face and I want a burrito. I saw her face. I want a burrito. It's true. Oh my god. The Monkees, the Archies. I've never heard of the Archies. I did something bad. T Swift. I gotta learn more T Swift songs. I just excuse me, started just T. Just started diving into some Taylor Swift. And all the hype, honestly, it's true. She's amazing. I love her. I drink wine, Adele. These are some good songs. All right. Ooh, 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 ooh. I just thought of one. Okay. This is, I don't know if you're going to know that. You probably know this one. Was this a hit? Okay, this is by the Eagles. But it's not their usual singer. I think it's their, like, bass player? Is it their bass player? I don't know. let's see. D. No. B. Yeah. Shoot. How's this one go? Yeah. Tell me if you know this one.
Look at us, baby, up all night, tearing our love apart. Aren't we the same two people who lived through years in the dark? Oh, every time I try to walk away, something makes me turn around and say, and I can't tell you why. When we get crazy, it just ain't right. Girl, I get lonely too, but you don't have to worry, just hold on tight, because I love you. Nothing's wrong as far as I can see. We make it harder than it has to be, and I can't tell you why. Oh no, baby, I can't tell you why. No, I can't tell you why.
I one time, an ex-boyfriend took me to an Eagles concert. It was a long time ago, and it was really fun. He was super into the Eagles, and I was like, "Oh, this is cool. I know some of their songs. I've been, you know, I listen to classic rock on the radio." And we sat down. The seats were awesome. It was on the floor. I was like, "Oh, this." He used to work at Bass Tickets, which became Ticketmaster, maybe. And so he'd get just like some cool perks of like you can purchase the tickets earlier with the pre-sale or something. And I sat down, and 30 seconds later, someone spilled an entire beer on me. So the entire Eagles concert, I was drenched and smelly, but it was still a good time. Yeah.
Nothing's wrong as far as I can see. You make it harder than it has to be, and I can't tell you why. Oh no, baby, I can't tell you why. No, I can't tell you why.
It is the most beer I have ever consumed, yes. I must be a beer magnet, because I also had the opportunity many, many years ago to play guitar, to be a background singer on the Jimmy Kimmel Show. How do you say that? I don't know. I'm so uncool. And it was really fun, but definitely 5 minutes before I went on stage, an entire Guinness was spilled on me. It was fun. I remember their hair and makeup people blow drying with these hair blow dryers, my dress before I went on. It's fun. I also smelled very bad. yeah. Okay, let's look at some of these comments. Thanks for listening, by the way. You guys are the best. I love you. Timothy B. Schmidt. Yeah, thanks, Bruce. It was Timothy B. Schmidt. I don't know if he sang many Eagle songs. Vince Gill did a cover. Oh, that's cool. cool. That's cool. Yeah, they're kind of like rock Americana, so country rock. So I that would make total sense. Drenched and smelly, yeah. At least it was a Guinness. It's the Guinnessy of all beers. I don't know anything about beer. I was made for you. Who does that? There's a heart in the way, so I can't read the last comment. That's so strange. There's also I'll be there for you. Who does that song? I'll be there for you. I swear to you. And you breathe. I wanna be the air for you. I'll be there for you. Who does that song? Come on. Is it like Bon Jovi or something? It's like, guess it's time you really leaving. How's that song go? I heard your suitcase say goodbye, and as my broken heart lies bleeding, just pulling them out of my, like, I used to learn all of these songs for these weddings. Say true love's a suicide. You say you cried a thousand rivers. Now you're swimming for the shore. You left me drowning in my tears. And you won't save me anymore. More. And I'm praying to God you give me one more chance, girl. I'll be there for you. These five words I swear to you. When you breathe, I wanna be air for you. I'll be for you, and words can't say what love can do. I'll be there for you. Can't believe I'm just like, what songs? I'm not putting this one in the tracker. Don't blame you. Oh man, anytime somebody would be like, learn this song. If I'd have a break, I'd go and learn it because back in the time, you'd survive on tips. And so I used to play these 4-hour casino gigs. Wrong tube. 4-hour casino gigs. And I learned that if you take a break, that's when people decide, oh, you know what, we're gonna leave. And sometimes they wouldn't tip you. So I learned as like, you know, I don't know how old you can be in a casino. Do you have to be 18? 21? Do you have to be 21? Anyway, I would be like, I would learn that you could just like smile at them as they're leaving. You know, this is you, watching them walk by and as you're singing, creepily smile at them until they we're like, oh yeah, I guess we should tip the band that's been playing for us these last 2 hours while we ate our steak. But sometimes they tip you in chips, and they're like, go throw it on a table or something. I'd be like, oh, I'll totally do that. And I would just cash it in immediately. I knew how to work it. These days, not so much. Jeff, you're making pizza? Let's go to Jeff's house. Jeff's making pizza. Pizza dough. Homemade pizza dough? Do you have a good recipe? Still searching for mine. I want to make sourdough pizza dough, but it always takes so long, so I stopped. Oh, Linda Ronstadt backing band, the Eagles. Ugh, good old Linda. Yeah, it is one of those boy bands, Bon Jovi. Yeah, I hear that. I'm not gonna say the next one though, Fred. You're so funny. Okay. It's funny that I remembered that though. Homemade pizza dough is the best. Oh no, I want pizza. I want pizza burrito. Oh, that I sound so good. Sounds terrible. Don't do that. Okay. What other one? I just thought of one, but it's gonna make Fradge really mad. I'll only play a little bit of it.
Oh yeah, I tell you something. I think you'll understand when I say that something. I wanna hold your hand. I wanna hold your hand. I wanna hold your hand. Oh, please say to me, you'll let me be your man. And please say to me, you'll let me hold your. It's such a feeling that my love I can't hide. Yeah, you got that something. I think you'll understand when I say that something. I wanna hold your.
Played that one because I like that. It's such a cute song. Want to know a little bit of trivia? So I want to hold your hand. I think it's like, it's cute, it's innocent, it's really sweet. And I loved that sentiment of holding hands as like such a way to show affection for someone. That it is one of the elements that inspired a nuclear love song. What's the whole title for that song? I don't remember. The one I play on ukulele at the end of Running on Machinery. Fratch. Such a great song. Okay, I'm sorry that you hate that one. Okay. Do I know any other I songs? Okay, I thought of, yeah. I can't tell if you're gonna like this one or not. I have a feeling you're gonna hate it. I'm sorry. I love you. Even if you hate the songs I'm playing. I think it's especially because you hate them. But hopefully one of these won't make you barf. So Jeff says, yes, pizza for today, and you make sourdough bread. But you always got to give love to the sourdough starter. So I have sourdough starter in my refrigerator that I haven't fed in months. I hope it's not dead. Okay, you've inspired me. I'm going to feed it after this. I'm going to feed my sourdough starter, see if it's still alive. And hopefully not. Poison us. Yes. Isn't this the band? Yeah, McCartney was in before Wings. It is! Okay, let's see if you hate this one.
I want you. I need you to need me. I'd love you to love me. I'm begging you to beg me. I want you to want me. I need you to need me. I love you to love me. new shirt. Get home early from work if you say that you love me. Didn't I see you crying? Oh, didn't I see you crying? Oh, feeling all alone without a friend, you know I feel like dying. Oh, didn't I see you crying?
Live version, he goes, I want you to want me. You gotta re-listen to that. I love you too, French. There's so many. You guys are, oh, I don't live today. Look at all of these songs. These are some good suggestions. Yes, that was Cheap Trick. That was definitely one that I would bust out at shows back when I was working the pub circuit. Yeah. The pub circuit. So many hiccups today. A double neck acoustic guitar. Part of me says no, absolutely not. The other part of me says yes, yes, yes. Okay. With all these song suggestions, somebody would be better getting married soon. It's true. It ain't me. You don't hate that one, but you do know some techs who would have had a bad experience with that band. Oh. See, this is called tea time for a reason. Because we drink the tea and we spill the tea. Love it. You're going to, oh, Beth, you're going to be at, oh, I don't know. Maybe I'll sneak into one of those Backyard Glen shows. That would be really fun. You're going to be in California for a long time. That's good. Well, 2 weeks. It's not a long time, but I'm glad. It would be lovely to see you. Yeah, I'll see you. I'll hit up KC and be like, yo, can I sneak into one of these? It's always fun. Glenn's so fun to watch. He's such a great performer. He's, be it with the band, be it with Toad, or just acoustic. He's always been one of my favorite onstage people. He's got good banter. Cheap Trick is opening for Heart. Are you serious? It's amazing. That's a cool bill. Okay, well, it's getting late. I'm going to get you to your Sunday, the rest of your Sunday. I got to feed my sourdough starter, and I have to ask my cat if he wants to get up at some point. Oliver, you hang out with the people? But I'll leave you with one more song. Let's see, what do I have in here? So we've done I Want to Hold Your Hand, I Can't Help Falling in Love, I Can't Tell You Why, I Want You to Want Me, I Won't Back Down, I Saw the Light, I Want to Be Sedated, and a Bon Jovi song, I can't remember the name of. Let's see, what else is on this song list? Do I remember? So, this is Megan of Yore. Do I remember this one? Not to leave you on a down note, but. That's coming to me.
Love of mine, someday you will die, and I'll be close behind and follow you into the dark. No blinding light, our channels of gates of white, just our hands clasped so tight, waiting for the hint of a spark. If heaven and hell decide that they both are satisfied and illuminate the no on their vacancy sign, if there's no one beside you when your soul embarks, then I will follow you into the dark. Catholic school is vicious as Roman rule. I got my knuckles bruised by a lady in black. I held my tongue as she told me, son, fear is the heart of love, so I never went back. If heaven and hell decide that they both are satisfied and illuminate the nook on their vacancy sign, if there's no one beside you in your soul embarks, then I will follow you into the dark. You and me, we've seen everything to see, from Bangkok to Calgary, and the soles of your shoes are all worn down. Time for sleep is now, nothing to cry about, 'cause we'll hold each other soon. In the blackest of rooms, if heaven and hell decide that they both are satisfied and illuminate the note on their vacancy signs, if there's no one beside you when your soul embarks, then I will follow you into the dark. Then I will follow you into the dark.
That is Death Cab for Cutie. Remember those guys? That's a great song. I love that song. I know a lot of people did that, covered that song, but I was one of them. But I like how it's kind of twisted and dark and beautiful. All of the things that I really attracted me to a song. And honest. I love that song. It's good. Anyway, thank you for listening. That one always gets me too. Let's read. Thank you for joining me for my tea time, y'all. It's like I always say, it's one of my favorite times of the month. And I'm gonna feed my sourdough starter, wake up my cat, and I am going to start on my Patreon song. And, you know, I'm going in with the idea that I'm going to write an 80s-inspired song. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. But it might turn out to be completely different, just like every month. Thank you. Now you're gonna go have a burrito. Happy tea time, happy burritos, happy pizza, and I love you guys so much. Thanks for joining me. Made my night, made my day. My brain's broken. I will see you guys soon. And stay tuned for the next Patreon song. Patreon song number 111? 12? One of those. Okay. Have a good rest of your weekend. Love ya.